Hi! You have killed the healer, Barbara Woodford, as you promised Azura. Troll's blood, dragon scales, twigs northern, clover, a cactus, a root bulb southern. Cool. And we can't loot that. I've been up there. I've been all over here. Kinda wonder if there's any passage left to explore at this point. Oh yeah, this way. Well, I can get there pretty easily, too. So let's see, am I seeing that right? Oh no, no, I took the wrong way. Oops. To the right. Down there? Yes. One of these, there was a secret door. I don't see that here. Oh, the humanity. See if there's anywhere we have, any place we haven't gone, and I don't see anything. I think it took me about as long to explore the very similar dungeon 2 episodes ago, or 2 and half of the last one. Crap in here. This will fund my efforts towards getting other summoning other Daedra. This place in the name of Daggerfall. I always do that before I travel, so we can hopefully get some training in. So the game crashed, but I'm happy about that, because we weren't supposed to go back to Daggerfall. We were supposed to go to Midbury. So let's go there. Unfortunately, this is going to bring us to where we are. Alright, let's take this stuff off before I forget. So you have a bad rep with commoners, merchants, and scholars with this, but it gives me wisdom and nimbleness so that I have. ...98 agility. ...92 strength on the other one. I thought someone was hurling a spell at me. Let's see. This one grants orc strength and strengthens armor. This one, wisdom. I'm actually not sure what wisdom falls under. A bit of poster board carrying an announcement has broken off and fallen to the ground. It appears to come from the king. You pick it up out of curiosity. I do? What do I do that for? Oh, I want to identify this thing. What the other stuff is. Steel Mace of Life Stealing. Vampiric effect when strikes. It's like my, some of my gear. Equipped it. All right, what do you want? No, I'm immune to disease. Okay. So we gotta find... How big a place is this? Well, this is reasonably big. Wow. This is a big city. So I gotta find... Morgabith Copperston. Halt! You there! Copperston, wasn't it? Mother Dragon? Morgabith Copperston. Alright, glitching out. Here we go. Oh, tell me about Azura. Why not? Ask someone else, Persephone. I'm running late myself. Go on and find a friend or someone who knows something. I ain't either. Parchment? Excuse me, Persephone. I actually have a life to lead. Okay, then. Now, how did I get there? Talk down? Oh, they like blunt. Lady Azura is a Daedra prince of vanity and egotism. He doesn't know anything about Azura's star, though. Parchment. Doesn't know where she is. Okay. I keep forgetting where I see it. I don't know what my issue is. Tell me about... Pardon me, Azura is one of the Daedric Regents of Oblivion. Her sphere is vanity. That's all I know. Could be anywhere. Okay. There's some more people. Bedenak. So it's under tell me about. Azura? Azura? I ain't gotta talk about Azura to nobody. Why would I want to help you? I did take this stuff off, right? No, I didn't. I was talking about it and didn't actually do it. Yeah, maybe now you'll talk to me. You wouldn't tell me even if I didn't know. Okay. Azura's star can transform living creatures into statues forever. I don't know. It takes their soul. Yeah, I don't think it turns them into... Nobody knows where she is. I'm new to Midbury too. Now please excuse me. This is a very big place. Pardon me, Morgabith Copperston. Is that sleepy-eyed young lady in green in Midbury's best book room? Never mind of here. That's all I know. Midbury's best book room? It's not listed here, this book room. Never mind of here. Okay. Looking for her. Some people don't want to tell us, some people can't tell us. It's a good story, it is. Morgabith Copperston is that young lady in green I saw daydreaming at Midbury's best book room to the... Never mind. They don't have a store called that. Oh, maybe I know something, but I'm not to talk about it. I don't particularly care to be your lackey, Persephone. Run along now. Midbury's best book room. Libraries? It's under library. Midbury's best book room. Alright, I'm just gonna start asking about that then. I thought it was under bookstores. I didn't realize it was a separate library section. Why the hell would I want to give you directions? I don't know. Decided to be a nice person. Help me, lady. Ah, thank you, pretty much. Oh, I didn't mean it that. Here it is. To the northwest. But there's something here. See, I hop over it. And that's interesting. Oh, I remember seeing, like, these dead trees before. Is this? Where is she? Morgabith Copperston. Oh, Persephone, have you been here long? I'm sorry, I was just daydreaming about my mistress, the Lady Azura. That candle reminded me of the scintillation of her eyes, you see. How silly of me. Well, here's Azura's star. She doesn't give this to just anyone, but don't let it go to your bean. She was mine first. Okay. Thank you very much. She will say no more. Magic items. Holding nothing. Worth 50,000 gold. Item powers. One target, save versus magic. Few mortals have the stomach to trade in souls. The Dark Brotherhood does it, as do certain groups within the Mage's Guild. For these cruel folk, Azura's Star has a particular fascination. The star acts as a reusable soul gem. The soul of any creature killed by the bearer of the star is trapped within it. If the star already carries a soul, nothing happens. Using Azura's star empties it, freeing the trapped soul to make its journey to oblivion. Azura's star can be used to make magical items over and over and over. Spells? None. Alright, so you have to equip it. Cool. And then, once you kill a non-human creature, it says. Well, it doesn't say here. You have the soul to use for enchanting. Now, I despise your kind, just go away. I'm not wearing the stuff. Yeah, I can't read. I mean, I can't buy this stuff. It's a library. You really ought to clean that up, you know. Well, that's awesome. So in the olden days, before I played this, you'd have to go in another huge dungeon because all the dungeons were huge. So this makes it a lot easier. Oh, look at this little balcony here, which you can't get other than by climbing. Look at my face. Why is it going in my face? Okay, back to Daggerfall. Streetwise improved. The city stinks like none you've ever encountered before. I stole this room in the White Muskrat for 52 hours. Oh. What's your name, stranger? I can't answer you. That's privileged information. And you're just not privileged. Mage's Guild, actually. Before I start looking for the next quest, let's fix our dagger. It looks like just our dagger. We can't fix magic items, unfortunately. So we go Thirsty Muskrat. Oh. That's where I have the room. Yet it was an unexplored place. That's weird. Well, the smith is to the east and a little south. That's gonna be the rest of the episode, just selling this stuff. And repairing the dagger. Because the Daedric dagger is awesome. Maybe they'll have some other Daedric stuff for sale. This is the Fighters Guild. Opens at 9. Hoy, Peristeer. Okay. So, let's also sell some stuff from our wagon. The elven longbow is 5 to 19 damage. The dwarven is 6 to 20. Okay. see if they have anything. Nope. Not a good selection, I'm afraid. Emperor's potions. Oh, this is a clothing store. Yeah, I'm sure you'll buy the Sanguine Rose for me. This isn't actually... Oh. He just won't buy my ingredients. What an ingrate. Oh, it's actually on my wagon, isn't it? That's right. I spoke too soon. Just making sure I took those pauldrons off. Lead... He doesn't have silver. Silver is the fourth ingredient for the mana or power potions. The hardest to find. The other one is Saint's Hair, Nectar, and Werewolf's Blood. So I have plenty of that stuff. But no silver. You can have all this stuff instead. I'm surprised he took the holy relic. That's it? That's all I get? 722 gold? Alright, so we have... This letter of credit, the 28,000 gold. And we also have 12,000 gold. I think we need 100,000 for... Do you have more in the bank? Pretty much straight south is the bank. Oops. I'm not sure I have enough to summon another Daedra. Unless I sell the star. I think I have more money in the bank than I took out. Oh yeah. I have 227,000 gold pieces. Zero. $12,000. And then I want to withdraw on a letter of credit. Oh, I hit the wrong thing. Letter of credit, I meant. Kinda broke now. Or I will be. So here's a letter of credit for 200,000. Here's a letter of credit for 28,000. And that's not how we get out of here. So the next quest, which I gotta work on, there's a list of the days. So we just summoned Azura. Next is Periite, if this is in chronological order by month, on Rain's Hand, 9 of Rain's Hand. And we get an artifact called Spellbreaker, which is a Dwarven Warhammer. Cast Paralysis and Vampiric Touch on Strike. That one I'll sell because I stink with blunt weapons. Anyway, that'll be next. I'll be resting up at the inn, I suppose. We should head for that one where I have all those hours left. Anyway, thanks so much for watching, guys. See you next time. And always, seek adventure.